here we have Tokyo ESP. And the title alone pretty much gives away that it's an Esper anime, but I've only seen a few anime that has Espers of some kind. And all of them had really great first episodes. So with this, I will definitely tell you right now, the first episode of this anime is really good. I liked it. It kept me interested. I wanted to know what was going to happen next, you know. But basically, it starts off with like a terrorist attack, where you have a bunch of espers that decided, you know, it kind of reminds me of like comic books with like Marvel and mutants and like X-Men type stuff and and regular humans. It was like the same thing for me, but in this case, the espers decided that they want to like run like Tokyo or Japan or whatever, and that the humans have no choice but to accept this, and they make it pretty clear that they see the humans as like bugs and insects, like they're not even remotely close to humans, which is kind of strange because, I mean, we're all human, but they don't see themselves that way. They see themselves as superior, so they want to take over. So they end up looking like, you know, a bunch of terrorists. They hijack the Tokyo like parliament building, and they're going forward with their plans. And then they mention from the actual reporter who is like reporting all these like events where espers are going crazy and just, you know, attacking things indiscriminately, which is all part of like whoever's the leader of these espers that took over. But the reporter mentions like a group that would save the humans, this white girl group, and they are espers, or she is an esper, but it seems that it's a group of espers that, you know, that's why it makes me think of like X-Men type stuff, because it's like a group of espers, like basically people with powers that's trying to stop other people with powers from like killing all the humans, or like, you know, like this terrorist esper group is doing now, like they stop them. So that's pretty much the story, like in like one go I was able to basically explain like the gist of the whole series. I feel that it won't go beyond that. I haven't watched the second episode. I want to, but I actually feel that it won't go outside what I've, you know, what I've already told you. And I think you should give it a watch. It's not bad. Not bad at all. Also, one last thing is I wanted to also give a nod to the Gaivray Zero intro, because this anime and Gaivray Zero is in the same setting, like same world, universe, however you want to look at it. And I thought that was a great anime as well, so you probably should watch that one first, because that one's pretty cool. Not that I think it has anything to do with this one. It's like they're just in the same world, but I like that anime too, so I think you should give that one a watch. Even though it's not a summer anime, it's old, but still, you should watch that one too. So here we have Hanayamada. And I'll tell you that with this anime, I didn't really understand what it was about at first, because I thought it was like I got caught off guard by one of the characters that made it seem like it was gonna be like a magical type anime, but I was wrong. But basically, it's about this girl who she's like completely normal and just average, and she doesn't like that about her. She doesn't like the fact that she's normal, that she's just absolutely average, that she's not extremely good at something. And she likes watching people who are good at things, that have this incredible talent. She envies it and wants to, you know, be just like them. But she understands that that she's just average, and that tells me that she's probably not just average. It's just how she feels about herself. But her name is Sakya Naru, and she runs into another girl who is like a foreigner from America, who is Hana Fountain Stand. That name, these weird names. Fountain Stand is just, I don't know. But yeah, so she meets this foreigner. She thought she was like a fairy or something like that. And because I mean, she's already doing things that is like strange. Like when she first runs into her, she's already like jumping, you know, from place to place, and that's like very dangerous. But there she is doing it, and instead of using the sidewalk like normal people. So she thought she was some sort of fairy or something, because she, you know, stands out. But now the very predictable part is she ends up transferring into Naru's school. So that's where, you know, the anime truly begins, where you learn more about Hana Fountain Stand and learn that she wants to do a yosekai dance. And that's like her dream, that's her goal. And she's been trying to convince Naru to do it too, but Naru doesn't want to do it. She's like very reluctant to do it. But of course, as you can guess, in the end, she will be convinced to, you know, to at least, you know, help. At least that, from her own words, to help. But I'm sure she'll get caught up in it and start doing it, and probably find that she is actually very good at something. So that's what I predict. But it's not like my type anime, but I didn't feel it was a really bad one either. So I recommend you guys watching 3 episodes before deciding whether you like it or not. And here we have Sabagibu, Survival Game Club. Now, it becomes very clear in the beginning of the anime that it mainly focuses on comedy. And the story is pretty much about this transfer high school student whose name is Sanokawa Momoka. And Momoka, basically, I guess her parents travel a lot, and she's transferred into like a whole bunch of schools. So basically, this is like yet another new school for her, and she's just doing the routine that she's comfortable with, which is basically playing like a really nice, saintly like girl. And she discovers on the way to her new school that everything is not quite like she thought it would be. Like, everything was going normal. She had an incident on the, you know, on the train on the way to school, but She thought I was just an isolated incident, no big deal. Until she got to school where she meets, I guess the club captain or of the survival game club. And that she met in the train on the way to school. And they have like some obsession with guns. And like, you know, doing the sort of things that people with like, you know, like paint guns and stuff like that would do. And so, like, that's what their whole club's about, getting all these guns and like, doing, like, survival game type setups and pitting each other, you know, against, you know, not only, like, the environment, but each other. And she kind of gets, like, caught up in there. Like, she's trying to find out who this woman is because it's like she was on the train with the guns, and now here she is in the school with the guns. She's thinking, like, this school is crazy. But everything is completely, like, different than what she expected. Like, all the girls in the school, and it's an all-girls school, by the way, but all the girls in the school, you know, like her, and she's like an idol in the school. So it's like, and she carries all these guns. So it's like, okay, this is not the typical school that I transferred into. And all the while, she's trying to follow this club leader, which I'll just tell you her name is Mio. And she follows Mio to the club, which she didn't know at the time, but ends up falling for a trap, which I'm sure you guys would have already like seen coming. But she is like basically handcuffed in her club, and they call her a spy and stuff like that. And they had her shoot, you know, guns, and she had like a bullseye, and ever since then, like, this Mio has been trying to get her in the club any way possible, and try to trick her into getting in the club, but she doesn't want to join, and as you know, like, in the end, like, she manages to, like, knock her out to like, get her in the club, but, yeah, you can tell it's like full of comedy. I wasn't busting up laughing, but it doesn't mean that anyone else watching it might not find it extremely hilarious. So give it a watch and tell me what you think. And there you have it. That is pretty much the last episode for the summer anime season that I will be uploading. But I know there's more, but I felt like these are the ones that I wanted to, you know, put out there for people to see. And a lot of them, there's a lot of sequels too. I typically like don't do the sequels if, because you should already know what it is if you saw the first one, so I didn't want to like really put up any like sequels, but soon the fall anime season will begin, and I'll have a whole lot more for you. So once again, hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.